Sarah Ferguson is the Duchess of York. She's a best-selling novelist, a children's book author, and she's been a national spokesperson for Weight Watchers. She's involved in several charities as well. She's also the mother of two daughters, Princess Beatrice and Princess Eugenie.
Her latest book is called A Most Intriguing Lady, a novel of the Victorian era. And Sarah Ferguson, Duchess of York, joins us live. Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning, Larry. Good morning, Lauren. It's lovely to see you today. And I'm glad you have a producer from England, from Preston.
We do, Matt. Yeah.
I love historical novels. Yours was inspired by an ancestor. Can you tell us about that?
Yes, Larry. It's very exciting because during the pandemic, I'd suddenly decided, wow, how is it I'm so strong and resilient and feisty and all these different things, redheads?
Uh-huh.
So I researched. My great-great aunt was Lady Margaret, and I wrote my first novel, which hit the best-selling list. So I thought, okay, maybe they'll give me another novel. Sure enough, they did. And Lady Mary is she's very demure during the day. Don't be fooled. After hours, she turns into a super sleuth, and she solves society crimes. But she has to go in disguise to the eerie back streets of East End of London in the fog, and so it's very saucy. This book is me. I'm becoming more confident as I write, so I'm hoping the next book will be even more confident. But this one is really, I'm really proud of it. It's very fast pacing and very, very me. You know. I've survived. I'm a resilient. I'm strong, and I'm a woman that's not going to be put down. I'm a woman that's going to speak her voice. And so I took Lady Mary's voice and said, "Okay, darling, here you go. You got my voice. Let's go." So it's very much more about my experiences in this.
And you speak about all these personality traits that you have, the feistiness, the ability to have your own identity. And how do you think that those traits have maybe carried over into the next generation of royalty?
Well, I think the best thing you can do, whether it's royal or not, is lead by example. Mm-hmm. And I've always said that to my children: put your face mask on yourself, and then get out there. And you know, I think when you have a lot of responsibility when you're in public life, and I popped over to Poland a few weeks ago, just to go and see all the refugees that are in Warsaw and in Upper Silesia, just to say, don't give up. You know, we're here with a voice. And look, I'm talking to Chicago now, saying to women out there, never give up.
What are your thoughts about the upcoming coronation in the midst of this family split that we've all been given a peek to, unfortunately?
Well, you know what, Larry? I really think that the king would be very, very proud of his grandchildren, as we know. I mean, it really, honestly. I mean, of course, Diana and I would have a granny off, and she would always win because she's much quicker than me. But he would be so proud. And I'm glad he's going to be crowned. I think he's done an enormous amount for the environment, and he is very, very kind. He's a very, very dear man. I've known him all my life. And I feel really strongly that he needs to be given this chance with his wonderful Camilla, who's so supportive of him, the Queen. And I just think we need to get on. And I really do, Lauren and Larry, I really believe strongly, everybody should stop. Actually, I've got a quote, which if you give me one more second.
Yeah, absolutely.
That this is what the Queen said. She said, "Remember that good spreads outwards, and every little does help." So don't forget that as human beings, we generally know what is right and how we should act and speak. But we are also very aware of how difficult it is to have the courage of our convictions. So no judgment, be convicted in what you want to do, carry on and do it, and then hold the line. Yeah. I mean, these are the quotes from the Queen.
Sure.
And for me, I think that Larry, in answer to your question, more kindness, less judgment.
Yeah, well said.
There's been so many depictions of the royal family, and I was curious, with your relationship with Queen Elizabeth, have there been moments that you've been able to reflect on that relationship and what you learned from her?
Oh my goodness!
Yeah,
oh my goodness.
I know.
Every time I was with Her Majesty, I would literally pinch myself. I really kept up the standards. You know, she gave you that feeling of awe that when you're with someone like that, you sit properly and you never cross your legs, and the etiquette is properly done, and And I always felt that. And I used to call it gravel fever. So when you drive up to go and see the Queen, the gravel would make a noise. And then you'd get in the door and curtsy, and the corgis would stand behind you and you'd kick the corgis. And then my mother always said, never curtsy near furniture because you'll topple over. You
know, that's good advice.
So one of the things was, you know, she always said, the last thing she said to me was, Sarah, please be yourself.
Yeah.
That is great. So great to talk to you. Once again, the book is called A Most Intriguing Lady. And good luck with the book, and we'll look forward to the next and talk to you then.